Drop a like and do share. Leave your comments and do not forget to subscribe for more videos.
Hello everybody, welcome to Edupedia World. This is Mansi Garg, your tutor for today, and we will be studying ocean currents. Ocean currents are large masses of surface water that circulate in regular patterns around the oceans. That is, for example, the North Atlantic Drift, the Labrador Current, the Benguela Current, etc. As you can also see on your screens. Based on temperature, ocean currents can broadly be divided into two categories, the warm current and the cold currents. The warm currents are those currents which flow from the low latitudes in tropical zones towards the high latitudes in the temperate and the subpolar zones. They bring warm water into the cold water areas. The warm currents are marked with red arrows, as you can also see on your screens, while the cold currents are marked with blue arrows. Let us now see what the cold currents are. The cold currents have a lower surface temperature and bring cold water into warm water areas. These currents flow in the high latitudes from the polar regions towards the low latitudes in the warm equatorial region. Some of the cold water currents are the Humboldt Current, the West Australian Current, the Californian Current, as you can also see on your screens. Based upon their depth, the ocean currents can also be divided into two other categories, which are the surface current and the deep water currents. The surface currents constitute about 10% of all the water in the ocean and lie at the upper 400 meters of the ocean. Whereas the deep water currents make up the other 90% of the ocean water. These waters move around the ocean basins due to variations in the density and gravity. Deep waters sink into the deep ocean basins at high latitudes, where the temperatures are cold enough to cause the density to increase. You must all be wondering what causes ocean currents. Well, there are many factors. Let's come up to them. The ocean currents have a regular pattern of circulation of water around the oceans. The origin and nature of the movement of currents are related to many factors such as the level of salinity, temperature, Earth's rotation, planetary winds, and land. Let us discuss these features one by one. First, coming on to level of salinity. You all know that level of salinity is directly proportional to the density of water. The higher the level of salinity of ocean water, the denser it is. Water with less salinity therefore flows over the denser saline water. For example, the Mediterranean Sea is more saline as compared to the Atlantic Ocean. So the Atlantic Ocean water flows into the Mediterranean Sea's surface. Coming on to the second factor, which is temperature. The oceans near the tropics and equator are much warmer than the ocean water in the polar or temperate regions. Therefore, warm equatorial waters move towards the poles as warm currents, while cold ocean currents move towards the equator as cold ocean currents. Coming on to the third factor, which is the Earth's rotation. In causing the ocean currents, Earth's rotation plays a very big role due to the Coriolis effect which it causes on the Earth. The Coriolis effect causes moving objects in northern hemisphere to veer clockwise. And simultaneously it causes moving objects in southern hemisphere to move counterclockwise. This happens because as the Earth rotates, different latitudes travel at different speeds. The change in speed with latitude causes the Coriolis effect. Since the speed of rotation of the Earth is maximum at the equator, all moving bodies, be it winds or ocean currents, move in a clockwise direction in the northern hemisphere and in the anti-clockwise direction in the southern hemisphere. For example, the Canary Current and the Gulf Stream in northern hemisphere and the Peruvian and the West Wind Drift in southern hemisphere. Coming on to yet another factor, which is the planetary winds. Planetary winds are caused due to greater heating of Earth's surface near equator as compared to solar heating near the north and the south poles. The planetary winds play a dominant role on the flow of ocean currents. As you can see, the planetary winds are categorized as trade winds, westerlies and polar easterlies, which blow both in the northern and the southern hemispheres. Coming on to trade winds. Trade winds blow between the equator and the tropics. These winds move equatorial waters polewards and westwards. They warm the eastern coasts of the continents. For example, the northeast trade winds move the north equatorial current to warm the eastern coasts of Japan as the Kuroshio current, while the southeast trade winds drive the south equatorial current, which warms the eastern coast of Australia as the warm East Australian current. As you can see in this map also, the warm currents are marked with red arrows, while the cold currents are marked with blue arrows. The cold currents are the ones which travel from the poles to the equator, while the warm currents are the ones which travel from the equator to the poles. Well, coming on to westerlies, the westerlies blow in the temperate latitudes and result in a northeasterly flow of water in the northern hemisphere and the opposite in the southern hemisphere. For example, the westerlies force the warm Gulf Stream to the eastern coast of Europe as the North Atlantic drift, as you may also see on your screens. They cause the cold west wind drift to flow towards the equator and the Peru current along South America and Benguela current along South Africa. Well, these were some of the factors which caused ocean currents. There are many, but since these are the main ones, we are limited to the discussion of these only. Coming on to the circulation pattern of ocean currents. The ocean currents are greatly influenced by the stresses exerted by the prevailing winds and Coriolis force. The oceanic circulation pattern roughly corresponds to the Earth's atmospheric circulation pattern. The air circulation over the oceans in the middle latitudes is mainly anticyclonic, which is more pronounced in the southern hemisphere than in the northern hemisphere. The oceanic circulation pattern also corresponds with the circulation of air. At higher latitudes, where the wind flow is mostly cyclonic, the oceanic circulation follows this pattern. In regions of pronounced monsoonal flow, the current movements are influenced by the monsoon winds, such as in India. Due to the Coriolis force, the warm currents flow from low latitudes to move to the right in the northern hemisphere and to the left in the southern hemisphere. The cold waters of the Arctic and Antarctic circles move towards warmer waters in tropical and equatorial regions, while the warm waters of the lower latitudes move polewards. Let's discuss some of the major oceanic currents one by one, the first one being the Gulf Stream. The route of the Gulf Stream you can see on your screens marked with red. The Gulf Stream, together with its northern extension towards Europe, the North Atlantic Drift, is a powerful, warm and swift Atlantic Ocean current that originates in the Gulf of Mexico, exits through the Strait of Florida and follows the eastern coastlines of the United States and Newfoundland before crossing the Atlantic Ocean. At about 30 degree west, 40 degree north, it splits into two, with the Northern Stream crossing to the Northern Europe and the Southern Stream recirculating off West Africa. The Gulf Stream influences the climate of the east coast of North America from Florida to Newfoundland and the west coast of Europe. In fact, the climate of Western Europe and Northern Europe is warmer than it would otherwise be due to the North Atlantic Drift, one of the branches from the tail of the Gulf Stream. Its presence has led to the development of strong cyclones of all types, both within the atmosphere and within the ocean. The Gulf Stream is also a significant potential source of renewable power generation. Now coming on to the second ocean current, which is the North Atlantic Drift. The North Atlantic Drift is a warm Atlantic Ocean current which runs from the Grand Bank near Newfoundland to Western Europe. In fact, the warm Gulf Stream current is deflected towards the east under the influence of the westerlies and the rotation of the earth and reaches Europe as the North Atlantic Drift. It is a warm current that keeps the ports of Europe free from ice even in winters. It flows in three directions, eastwards to UK, northwards to the Arctic region and southwards along the Spanish coast as the cool Canaries current. Coming on to the third ocean current under discussion, which will be the Labrador current. The Labrador current is a cold current in the North Atlantic Ocean which flows from the Arctic Ocean south along the coast of Labrador and passes along Newfoundland, continuing south along the east coast of Nova Scotia. It is a continuation of the West Greenland current and the Baffin Island current. It meets the warm Gulf Stream at the Grand Banks southeast of Newfoundland and again north of the outer banks of North Carolina. The combination of these two currents produces heavy fogs and has also created one of the richest fishing grounds in the world. In spring and early summer, this current transports icebergs from the glacier of Greenland southwards to the transatlantic shipping lanes. The waters of the Labrador Current have a cooling effect on the Canadian Atlantic provinces and coastal New England, but rarely have a significant effect on the waters south of Cape Cod. Well, coming on to the second set of currents, we are going to discuss the currents of Japan, which comprise of the Oyashio, Kuroshio and the Tsushima Current. You will get to know that the Tsushima Current is a part of the Kuroshio Current only. So let's discuss the Kuroshio Current. Kuroshio Current is a strong western boundary current in the western North Pacific Ocean. It begins off the east coast of Taiwan and flows northeastwards past Japan, where it merges with the easterly drift of the North Pacific Current. It is analogous to the Gulf Stream in the Atlantic Ocean, transporting warm tropical water northwards towards the polar region. It is also sometimes known as the Black Stream, the English translation of Kuroshio, and an allusion to the deep blue of its water, and also as the Japan Current. Its counterparts are the North Pacific Current to the north, the California Current to the east and the North Equatorial Current to the south. The warm waters of the Kuroshio Current sustain the coral reefs of Japan, the northernmost coral reefs in the whole world. The branch into the Sea of Japan is called the Tsushima Current. It brings rich fisheries from the East China Sea into the Sea of Japan. There is a concentration of uranium passing through this current every year, which is between 5 and 6 million tons. The Japan Current is also responsible for the mild weather experienced around Alaska's southern coast. Coming on to the next current in discussion, which is the Oyashio Current. It's the last current that we'll be discussing today. The Oyashio Current is a cold subarctic ocean current that flows south and circulates counterclockwise in the western North Pacific Ocean. It collides with Kuroshio Current off the eastern shore of Japan to form the North Pacific Current. The waters of the Oyashio Current originate in the Arctic Ocean and flow southwards via the Bering Sea. This current has an important impact on the climate of the Russian Far East, mainly in Kamchatka and Chukotka. The waters of the Oyashio Current form probably the richest fishing grounds in the world owing to the extremely rich nutrient content of the cold water and the very high tides, which are up to 10 meters in some areas, which further enhances the availability of nutrients. It also causes Vladivostok to be the most equator-ward port to seasonally freeze and requires ice-breaking ships to remain open in the winter. However, this has relatively little effect on the fish yield through the Sea of Okhotsk because the large tides means freezing does not occur so easily. Ocean currents, we have discussed many of them. Now let us discuss the effects that they have, which are numerous in nature, like the effect on temperature, the effect on rainfall, the effect on fog. They are the cause of violent storms, the effect on marine organisms and on commerce finally. So let us one by one discuss them. The climate of the coasts becomes warm or cool according to the current washing the coast, which may be warm or cool. So first let us discuss the effect on temperature. Warm or cold ocean currents flowing near a coast exert a significant climatic influence. Look at your screens where the warm equatorial currents tend to raise the temperature of the places where they flow. The Labrador current remains frozen for 9 months on account of the influence of the cold Arctic current, while the British Isles enjoy a mild climate on account of the influence of the North Atlantic drift. The otherwise hot climate of Peru is greatly cooled down by the Peru current. On account of the influence of North Atlantic drift on the harbors of Norway, even beyond the North Cape are free from ice throughout the year, while Greenland in the same latitudes is ice bound all the year round. The warm Kuroshio current keeps the port of Alaskan coast ice free in winters also. Coming on to the second one, which is the effect on rainfall. The air above the warm ocean current becomes warm and acquires greater capacity to absorb moisture. Thus, the winds help in increasing the amount of precipitation in the affected coastal areas. For example, the North Atlantic drift, the Kuroshio current, bring in sufficient rainfall along the western coasts of Europe and eastern coasts of Japan respectively. On the other hand, the cold currents discourage rainfall. For example, Kalahari Desert along the western coast of South Africa and Atacama Desert along the western coast of South America owe their existence to some extent to Benguela and Peru currents respectively. Coming on to the third aspect, the effect on fog. Dense fog occurs when the warm and cold ocean currents meet. The air above the warm current is warm and acquires a lot of water vapor. When it meets the cold air above the cold ocean currents, the warm vapors of the warm air are condensed into minute water particles which form fog. The Japanese coast has dense fog when the warm Kuroshio current meets the cold Oyashio current. Similarly, Newfoundland, where the warm Gulf Stream meets the cold Labrador current, creates a dense fog. Let's discuss one other effect, which is violent storms. Violent storms follow the line of meeting of cold and warm currents, just like fog occurs. The hurricanes, which occur off the coast of United States, follow the line where Gulf Stream mingles with the cold Labrador current. Let us discuss the effect on marine organisms also. The sea has innumerable microscopic organisms which are called planktons. The fish feed on the planktons. Ocean currents move organic material off the coast, which is the food of planktons. The more the planktons, the higher the concentration of fish. Coming on to effect on commerce. On account of the influence of warm currents, harbors are kept open in winter, facilitating trade throughout the year. For example, the coasts of UK, Norway, etc. should normally freeze in winter, but due to warm ocean currents, they remain unfrozen and trade remains unfettered. In fact, the warm Gulf Stream, which affects even such a place as Spitsbergen, which is situated deep in the north. Montreal at the mouth of St. Lawrence River remains open for the whole year, but Vladivostok is snowbound for almost the whole year due to cold current along the coast. Sailing vessels are aided or hindered by the direction of currents. Such vessels from England are bound for Australia to move towards Rio de Janeiro in order to have a favorable current across the South Atlantic and the Southern Ocean. Danger to ships is caused by the icebergs that flow in cold currents. Due to fog, the ships are not able to locate them. Many ships have sunk on account of accidents with these icebergs. However, in modern times, radar helps the ships to locate icebergs even in the darkness of dense fogs. So, that was it from my side on ocean currents. Thank you and have a nice day.